Nietzsche was right when he said there must be chaos in the soul to give birth to a dancing star. And I cannot believe in a God who does not dance. I believe the absolute hope embodies the idea of dancing, that there can be this jubilant, joyous surreality into which we jump. If we can become more childlike, not just physically when it comes to pliability, when it comes to mobility, when it comes to flexibility, etc., but also on a holistic level, if we can have the mindset, the awe, the shudder with wonder that ladders up the spine, then we're going to have a lot more joy. I think we grow up, we grow old, we grow jaded, we grow cynical to the point where we lose what it really means to live, to have zoe, to have the overflowing, over and above, superfluous, super abundance of real living. So I want to go back to the childhood
Of
days,
being
excited to be alive and experiencing that now. Nietzsche said that life is far too short to bore ourselves. If you're going to discipline yourself, which I fully advocate, then you have to do it regarding the things that make you interested, intrigued,
intrigued.
curious, things that you believe in, because if you don't, you're going to find yourself full of unwanted remorse.
I did not do anything.
Oh, what about?
You have 40 more seconds.
Biggest eats.
Two, three.
What's my advice?
Or,
what?
Look at Toby.
Well, look at it.
He's such a big boy.
You just don't want dirt to
No, you're
slip
smart.
out of there.
There's this great Nietzsche idea that if you try to go against the tribe or the hive mind or the herd, you're going to encounter loneliness and you might feel frightened. But what you gain and the price that you pay, what you get for it, is you own yourself. And this is one of the greatest privileges of all, when you can say, you know what? I truly am a man of knowledge. I really am a person that belongs to my own self. On a solipsistic level, I am not influenced by what other people say I should be, but rather I own myself in that I'm being true to who I was created to be. Sure, sometimes you have to plan for spontaneity. If you're looking for and forward to those magic moments, you got to put it on the calendar, you got to put it on the books. That being said, some of my most cherished and adored memories come from times that I didn't have on the calendar, that I didn't have on the books. They just happened in the moment. It's like a colony of ants or the emergence of consciousness. They just apparated and appeared out of seemingly nothingness, ex nihilo.
These look like brother and sister. You guys look like bro and
No.
sis. Is that mama koala and baby koala?
Like wisps of a flame that emerge into existence out of the nothing. So, too, if you look forward to and set yourself up for those unplanned moments, that's where the real thing happens. Ex nihilo, bara, tohu va bohu. So much gratitude, so much thankfulness. When I look around, I feel so fortunate. But it's not just feeling fortunate, it's something more than that. I feel truly divinely endowed with the something plus, with the lightning in a bottle, when I just realize how good the absolute hope has been to me. Even listening to my cat fridge meow in the background, being next to the beach, being filled with Zoe, I can't help but look around at my life and say, through all the hard things I've been through, now coming out on the other side, I just feel nothing but deep gratitude. Make sure you delve deep into thankfulness today. After a wondrous weekend with my dad visiting Santa Barbara, my dad, for whom and to whom I am forever grateful, and then getting to train with my buddy Shavit again today, as we regularly do, I am so thankful for these things today. When you stop to think about what you're grateful for today, watch how it will actually boost your joy levels. Take a moment to be grateful. Nietzsche was right when he said to those on the ground, the ones who fly look very small.
Oh, dang.
What did you wish for, Michael?
How could I
I can't tell
regret
you.
what'd you wish for,
I can't
Fidel?
say.
What'd you wish for,
Good
dude?
job. Ben's gonna make you
I did
drop
not
it.
even. It's not my birthday.
Happy birthday, Brighton. I was thinking about playing checkers on your beanie. How does it feel? Oh, he's back! His
birthday.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Brighton. Happy birthday to you.
One of the most helpful and therapeutic things that I can think of, both physically and mentally, when it comes to muscle recovery and mind rejuvenation, is cold water therapy. I've been doing it every day, taking cold showers every day for as long as I can remember, and it has brought me so much healing. Did you know the ancient Greeks in olden times actually utilized cold water for therapies as well as for just socializing and relaxing? The famous medical doctor Hippocrates in the 4th century BC, he actually records and documents the use of cold for medicinal purposes and analgesic advantages. In Hippocrates' work entitled On Airs, Waters, and Places, he actually says that water can cure everything, further emphasizing the incredible import of therapy found in water. The wardrobe effect is a potent portal that brings us into a land of magical animals and starry nature. When we anthropomorphize animals' feelings, realizing that they feel like humans feel, they can feel sad, they can feel happy, they can feel the things that we feel, then we're going to want to treat them with the utmost adoration, admiration, and care. So can I encourage you to go into this wonderful cosmos, this well-ordered system that the Absolute Hope has given us, and to love its creatures with an ardent fervor? Via Dewey's reconstruction, pragmatism, if it's useful, it's true, so too, north, south, east, and west are human add-ons, not inherent to the objective cosmos, but rather we created that object of knowledge. So too, through epistemological idealism, we can curate and spawn add-ons to the world based on our inquiry and perceptions. I found life to be much more enriching when I'm not politicking, because much of the political narrative is internal dialogue grafted onto and sublimated into externals, an escape of oneself or running away from the truth that a man must pull himself together because no one else can. Nietzsche confessed that he too went on a short sojourn, whereupon he entertained thoughts about matters that did not concern him, which he called the first symptom of political infection. Even the finest minds, minds that have planted atavistic and mimetic germs of hope into the future, have not been immune to the disease. It's time to break the mold. Instead of getting involved in those things that touch us by an implicit, twice-removed, faraway connection, let's experience life immediately. The Hegelian geist is implicitly linked to two of our English words, gist and geyser. Geist haunts us, pun intended, seeing as it's the German word for ghost or spirit. It materializes in the flamingo feather neon pink clouds of gloaming, the elastic steel waves of second darkness at sea, and in nostalgia. Geist, the wellspring underneath it all, bubbles up in the gist of nature. It is everything, or if you'll suffer a slightly mixed metaphor, noumenon laps up onto the shores of phenomenology. Haven't you felt it? It's hard to believe we're mere atoms in a void when your cat plays with you by going outside your window and meowing with you until you acknowledge him, or looking at a twilight gloaming at eventide.